Yes, this is a couch.
Yeah, I don't know about that, but
we're about to move on to the elimination match of Group C. It's going to be between Reynad and Ostkaka. And we talked a little bit about this matchup before, but we were saying it's not really what we expect coming in, but this group is actually one of the most stacked. You have Reynad, Ostkaka, Doublelos, and then Roger. A lot of these players well-known for their recent tournament performances, especially. Maybe not Doublelos since he's a new player,
right.
But it's a pretty scary group.
Yeah. And, I mean, Doublelos came through a pretty huge open. He actually went down in round one, which meant he had to win more rounds than anyone in the lower bracket.
Right.
I believe he went 8-1 in that tournament. So, you know, while he might not have the tournament performances at any lands, he's definitely shown his worth online in some tournaments.
Yeah,
definitely. Going through the entire loser's bracket for that last chance open is really tough, and it's a lot more pressure because, you know you can't lose to fall out of the tournament. So it was very impressive that he was able to do that. I know every time I fall into losers, I'm just like...
Yeah, a lot of people just give up
when
you fall into losers. It feels like a mountain, and you're just like, nope.
Yeah, I remember the story that you were telling me, Domdus, when you made it through one of the open weeks that you qualified to the Legendary Series. You said you were playing on your tablet.
Right.
What was that story?
So I was... The Legendary Series week that I made it to for the open that I played in, I was out with my family all day from all the way till maybe like 6 or 7 at night. But I really wanted to play in it because I knew it was the last week for the Legendary Series. So I was like walking around with my tablet the entire day, you know, mingling with like all my like family and friends and stuff while trying to play. And it just led to a lot of awkward moments because I'd like keep looking down while they're talking to me and playing. And it led to a lot of huge mistakes. But somehow I got lucky, got through, and the rest is history.
And now you're here.
Now I'm here, right? So anything's possible, guys. Anything.
Yeah. Follow your dreams.
Hearth is life, TJ.
Yeah.
A message
Don't
from Domdus.
Yeah.
And then he walked outside after the family gathering, and there was a rainbow.
Yes. I dropped to my knees and was like, hallelujah, I'm in.
All right, well, you can see the decks there on your screen. Reynad has the Hunter, the Patron Warrior, and the Tempo Mage. Ostkaka, on the other hand, he has Rogue, one of the few players to bring Rogue in this tournament thus far. He had the Handlock as well, and then his third deck was...
Patron Warrior.
All right.
So, bit of a difference in decks from these players. Reynad with the Tempo Mage, which he said he was pretty happy with. I did hear that a day after deck list had been sent, there was a deck he became aware of, and he wished he had submitted that as his third.
Yeah. Right.
But says, you know, he sticks by the Tempo Mage is pretty good. We really do have yet to see it in tournament play.
Yeah.
Do have a really good performance. But here it is, first game against Patron Warrior. And he's going to keep Mirror Image and Sorcerer's Apprentice off the Mulligan.
I believe this is the second Tempo Mage we've seen, right? I believe Lead Paint brought one.
Lead Paint brought one and did not perform very well with it.
Right, yeah. Did not
do
too well.
The deck has yet to really do that great, but Double Mad Scientist is pretty good.
Once you get that Flame Waker out there and it goes crazy, it can definitely swing a lot of games.
I have seen some like 15 damage Flame Wakers before.
Yeah. Mad Scientist is the most overpowered in Mage because their secrets cost 3! It's the most mana efficient.
It is. You don't like that Paladin Mad Scientist value?
Those 1 mana.
Yeah. Aw, we only got to cheat out a 1 mana card. That's not overpowered enough.
Dang it.
Well, those mirror images that Reynad kept off the mulligan really proving annoying. Like, he's just going to have to axe them down over 2 turns.
Yeah.
Yep.
So, Sorcerer's Apprentice, Mad Scientist, both going to get in for a lot of damage.
He sort of just, like, primed it so that he could keep his valuable creatures alive for a few turns, like the Sorcerer's Apprentice. To open up more opportunities. I think this deck, as long as it gets going early.
It's definitely it's called Tempo Mage. You really need to seize the tempo of the game. And
who knew?
If you can get ahead, it is supposed to be one of the decks that can really run away with the game.
Yep. Definitely seen it many times snowball way out of control right in front of me and me being very sad.
And Reynad's even going to go for this really aggressive Frostbolt, just deny more weapon charges, and with a triple weapon hand from Ostkaka, that turns out to be a pretty good play.
Yeah, spot on.
I like it. Because he has Flame Cannon to deal with anything that comes down.
Yeah. Like,
what's the biggest thing that can come down this turn?
Berserker's not going to help. Yep. Even Acolyte of Pain, not going to help.
Armorsmith or Coin Gnomish Inventor. Something like that is... He's basically covered all his bases here.
And this is the point at which Patron Warrior is the weakest. Taunts and freezes are stopping the weapons. The minions do nothing against cards like Flame Cannon
and
for
here
one
comes
mana.
The Berserker.
And so here we're going to see a 3-mana for 1-mana trade. Just going back to the whole tempo thing, this is what Mage does best. Ooh.
And what a draw as well.
That's a nice draw.
Yeah, I don't know if you play it this turn, though. You might just develop the other Mad Scientist just to keep pushing damage.
It's definitely nice in the future, though, to be able to refill the hand a little bit.
Because his hand, that was the main concern coming up, was his hand was running very low on cards.
Yeah. And, I mean, we go back a little bit to how Ostkaka qualified. He actually made it through the open bracket for one of the weeks. But in the week he participated in, he went 0-6 in game. So he lost his first two matches and went 0-6.
Yeah.
He eventually made it through one of the redemption tournaments, but it took him a little bit of time to sort of warm up to the Legendary Series.
Right. So. Definitely took me a while, too, especially losing both in my Legendary Series week and my redemption tournament.
Yeah.
Yeah.
About that.
Yeah. It took me the longest amount of time. I'm still trying.
There's always Season 3, Chucky.
Always Season 3. Yep.
Some people may not have tuned into Legendary Series Season 1. Chucky actually took second place.
Yes, he did.
I know. What a surprise. He fell to Silent Storm in the finals, so he does have history with this tournament.
Yeah. I kind of know what it's like to be in those booths, you know, playing the game. And I think if you're Reynad here, you might not play that Sorcerer's Apprentice. You saw Ostkaka was very deliberate in replacing his previous axe with a Deathbite. He clearly wants the Whirlwind effect. And Reynad reads this, just gets that extra damage with the ping.
Yep.
It's going to pay off because he's probably going to get double Whirlwinded here.
We talked earlier about how one of Roger's strengths is sort of his focus and his preparation coming into matches. For Reynad, unfortunately, it's actually sort of the opposite.
Definitely.
So I'm not sure how much attention he was paying to the other players of his group sex. I mean, he's a busy guy. He's got a lot on his plate.
Oh, yeah.
He's talked about that in many interviews before. He's sort of the owner of his brand. So
first, right. Player second.
Yeah, and that's what he said. And so I'm not sure how much he knows.
In terms of this game specifically, you don't need to know much. Well, it's a Patron Warrior
Something
deck.
Like Brawl, you may not know. It's a tech card.
It's a Patron Warrior deck.
Yeah.
So Ostkaka's going to get the cards before Whirlwinding to play around something like Counterspell, which it's very likely Reynad has since he played two Mad Scientists without any hesitation. But we do only see one secret pop out, which is almost certainly Mirror Entity.
So we've yet to see sort of the engine for the Flame Wakers here and the Archmage Antonitis.
Well, I'm sure there are a lot of spare part cards, maybe Mechanical Yetis, Clockwork Gnomes.
I predicted the Toshli as well, Reynad.
Potentially Toshli.
He really likes that card. Not even in just Temple Mage. He really likes the card in general.
It's very similar to Boulder Fist Ogre with a little bit of utility. And I've used Boulder Fist Ogre in some tournaments before.
What now?
Way back when.
The Arena Master. Night.
Yeah. Domnus, what do you think of Toshli?
I actually don't have him myself.
Whoa!
I don't know what to say about him.
Not our resident Toshli.
Nope. Unfortunately.
You know, it's not the greatest card ever. It's no Dr. Boom, but it's just a solid card that you can play on six. Hard to answer. Almost like a Savannah High main. Mirror Entity. Bad draw.
Yeah.
But, I mean, realistically, Reynad's still pretty far ahead.
Yeah, he's going down to 9 health and...
But how do you go about this is the problem. You can't really just slam Antonitis here. You really want to get those fireballs. And like we were talking about, how to get those spare parts. He has not had drawn any of those cards. So no spare parts.
None. And he's got two of sort of the spare part activators with the Flame Waker.
Three, kind of.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Make him free.
His hand is all one side of the synergy.
Yeah.
It always feels bad to be on the one-sided part of a relationship.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The relationship with your cards.
Yeah.
Yeah, when you're the sprint, but there's no prep.
Yep, just leaving you behind.
When you're the prep, but there's no sprint.
When you're the savage roar, but there's no force
when
of
you're
nature.
The juggler, but there's no unleash. Oh, man.
Bible.
How do you think Unleash felt when Buzzard just left? Just got up and left. Wow. Oh, you know the most abusive relationship in Hearthstone, though, is Argent Squire and Abusive Surgeon. He keeps abusing her, but she always sticks around.
Oh, I like it.
Wow!
That loot hoarder is a really important draw.
Yeah, let me just move on to something else.
Oh, wow, he's
one.
Just going to slam boom though. Oh, man, so he's going to execute this turn.
Definitely.
Yeah.
There go the boom bots.
Yeah, he can't really afford to sort of like play around the mirror entity anymore. He's got to start putting on pressure because he's sort of on a clock.
Boom bots. Oh. I wonder if he'll inner rage here. No, it looks like he's just going to trade.
He gained quite a bit of health. He's at 13, so yeah. Double fireball won't kill him next turn.
He's stabilizing.
Yeah.
And with Acolyte double inner rage, that's quite a bit of draw he can produce.
All right, esports.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Whoa! Look at that!
That was amazing.
Okay.
Well, if you don't have Toshley,
yeah, there you
just
go.
Take unstable portal.
Yeah, come on.
How convenient is that?
Yeah, you should have known. Wait a second. Is he dead? He's dead.
He is dead.
Oh!
Top decked!
All of that for
That is
okay. Hold on. Let's get the salt. Where's the salt shaker?
All right, here we go. Yes.
Top deck and wrecked.
Oh, yeah. I think that's just a perfect ending for Reynad.
Yeah, it was. It's like, it's finally.
Yeah. Finally, I'm the Toshley.
Finally, I'm lucky. No, not at all.
Salt.
Yeah. Ostkaka's like.
Ostkaka just like whoa. Easy.
So, yeah. That's awkward. You saw Reynad sort of roll his eyes at the end of that.
Well,
is there something wrong with my mouse? Show him the salt, Chalky.
There we go.
Pouring it on me.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, if you're Reynad, that's a tough one to lose. That mage deck, you know, you're already, that's kind of like your weak link. You're not as sure in that deck. I mean, he even said there was another deck he would have liked to have brought had he known about it.
Yeah.
And it was so close to winning.
He had a crazy start.
He did, yeah. He looked like he was in control of that the entire time.
Yeah. But then,
until he wasn't.
Until he died to the old 21 damage out of nowhere. Yeah. Fun game.
Sort of. It was a nice move by Ostkaka, though, to sort of say, I can't really afford to like play around Mirror Entity. I just have to sort of go for it. Use my execute now. Try and go on to the aggressive here.
That 4 damage to the face from the bombs really came into play.
Those could have hit the opposing
Perfect
Dr.
Bombs.
Boom.
Yep. Those bombs knew exactly what they were doing.
Yeah. Incredible. Well, that's only the first game, so Reynad, not out of this series yet. It is going to be tough for him, like you said, to find one with that weaker deck, the Temple Mage, which nobody's really been having success with so far this tournament.
That's the other side of the Mech Shaman coin.
Yeah. Mech Shaman.
Also not having any success.
Nope. Not having any failures this tournament either, though.
Yeah, it is.
There was a 0-3
Kabi did not succeed much.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah. So
that was something that I sort of tried to erase from my mind.
Two of the more unorthodox third decks very much showing why they're unorthodox.
Yeah.
But
so far, it's sort of been the story of...
Clearly, these players had success with these decks in their testing, though.
Oh, for sure,
I know this from previous experience. You know, you can find what you suspect to be a good third deck, and it does great in testing. You bring it to a tournament, and it just falls flat for a few games.
Mm-hmm.
That can happen. So
it's a small sample size. Imagine if in that little bit of a lull there for Reynad, if he drew something like a mechanical Yeti instead
of... Yeah, he really did miss kind of his mid-game.
Yeah.
He got the perfect early game, but then when the mid-game rolled around, he was drawing very awkwardly. And we talked about that Mirror Entity was an awful draw. It ended up being, like, just terrible. It did nothing.
The deck sort of is inconsistent. So that's something that you have to like keep in mind when you're choosing decks is you only have two chances to make it out of groups. Like, if you lose twice, you're out.
Yep,
you may not even get a chance for the deck.
Yeah, I know a lot of players tend to favor more like control-heavy decks, thinking that the later the game goes, the more I can potentially show my skill in the game, not completely rely on percentages, whereas aggro decks, tempo decks, kind of more like, no matter how good my opponent is, I'm still going to beat them this percent of the time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So, a lot of players tend to favor that control style, especially a lot of the people who qualify through the Olympics.
All right, Dominus, what do you think of Rogue?
I like it. I think it's definitely still one of the top decks. I know a lot of people regard it as still being really good. It just has so much burst potential out of nowhere and has, you know, good board clears with Blade Flurry.
Oh, man.
Oh, it's the tabbing is continuing right now.
He's not even tabbing. He's just scribbling.
It is 5,000.
That's a Misha. Write it down, TJ.
Eight. Oh, I mean 15.
Wait, 17. You said 16,
I don't know.
Man.
Lots of Mishas.
All right, Mishas lots of Mishas. Well, Misha and Leok were pretty bad. Huffer, actually, with the Edwin off the top, would have been even worse. But now he's going to make a 6-6 Edwin pretty soon.
Yeah, the amount of Mishas today has been unbearable.
And the stare down continues between Chalky and TJ.
Gotcha.
Got him.
Yeah. No, but, I mean, it has been Misha heavy today.
All
to
right.
be fair.
All right. Thanks, stats guy. Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to get to see another before this game ends. I think it'll be Huffer.
All right. Well, we'll see.
Here we go. It's probably going to calm down now.
No.
Oh. Yeah.
All right. Yes. I might have to adjust my prediction.
Leaving something on the board against Rogue can be really dangerous.
True.
Because one of the ways that Rogue wins in this matchup is by, like, racing. And
yeah.
You want to play your creatures on, like, an empty board to try and get the momentum
yeah.
going.
Imagine Ostkaka had a prep here. You would definitely prep Oil Edwin.
Oh,
yeah,
just definitely.
Just start jamming him in the face.
This is still pretty good. He's got Blade Flurry, too.
Yeah. He set up a backstab Oil next turn. He'll get to combo the Oil and get a 7-4 Edwin. Pretty hard to answer for Hunter, whose breakpoint is basically 3 with Quick Shot.
All
right. Also,
and he saw the kill
trap.
Command.
All right, well, looks like we're having a little bit of an issue there, but hopefully we'll get that resolved shortly.
Yeah.
He's like...
Looks like we have an issue on Reynad's end, maybe. Mm-hmm.
See, and that was a Misha. Are you sure the game's working correctly?
Yeah, yep. I guess so.
I thought that card summoned a 4-2 would charge.
Not this time. That would have been terrible for him, though. Mm-hmm. So...
Reynad sort of had the... It's sort of a hybrid hunter, but it's more mid-range heavy. He runs cards like Abusive Sergeant and Glaive Zuka, but we haven't really seen other one-drops from him. And
we haven't seen Leprechaun yet.
No Leprechaun, and he ran Sludge Belcher and Piloted Treaders, which is sort of like tell for mid-range hunter.
Right.
So what do you think this matchup is like against the Rogue? I know traditionally the Rogues are great against Face Hunter, but... What's the matchup sort of like against the hybrid or going more towards the mid-game? Chalky first.
It's pretty close to 50-50, I think, with this sort of mid-range kind of aggro.
Yeah.
If it had Leper Gnomes, I think it would improve more for the Hunter. But the more you go towards this mid-late game focused on Belcher, Savannah High Main, the more you get punished by Rogue cards like Sap, because Rogue is really dominant at controlling the board, and the way they lose is if you don't care about the board, and you just keep hitting their face.
Yeah.
So, you know, around 50-50.
Yeah. You agree, Dominus?
I have a similar viewpoint that, yeah, like, the more time you give Rogue to just be able to draw into all their big removals, you know, the higher chance they're going to win, of course, because they're just waiting for all that to burst you down.
Yeah.
So, with the slower Hunter, it definitely, I think, gears it a little bit more towards the Rogue's advantage.
Okay. All right, well, let us know what you guys think about what you've seen so far today at day 2 of the Legendary Series. It's been a fun day so far, so join in on those conversations. Tweet at us using the hashtag HLS, or you can follow us on Twitter at ESL Hearthstone. Also, we'd like to give a big shout-out to our sponsors. We've been able to fly 16 of the best players in the world out to Burbank, California to play for the $25,000 and the Blizzard World Championship points. Domdis, of course, included in those players. So we want to give a shout-out to them. If you want to check out some Plantronics headsets, maybe some Gigabyte motherboards, check out those links that you just saw below and support what we do here at the Legendary Series. And, it's been a good day so far. We've had some pretty good games. We've seen some interesting decks. We saw Of course, Double O's bringing the Feigned Death Hunter.
Mm-hmm.
And
the combo lock.
The combo lock as well. So I'm curious to see how the rest of the day is going to go. We have Group D after Group C today as well. Of course, that consists of players like Life Coach.
Right.
Silent Storm, Season 1 champion.
Season 1 champion. The man to take down the infamous Chalky.
He's the one.
He's here defending
multiple
his
times.
Crown. Multiple times. He beat many people. He beat Savitz multiple times, I believe.
Alrighty, well, Frodan is actually hanging out in the players area. He's joined by some special guests, so let's send it over to him.
That's right, Izumo. While we have a couple of minutes here to chat with the players, I feel like it's an opportunity to take this downtime to get to know PhoneTap a little bit better. Now, PhoneTap, he actually has won his first match already on Group D offstream. We have that to accelerate the matches for the schedule today. So how'd your games go specifically?
It was a very close series. It went down 3-2, and I'm happy I pulled off. In terms of the lineups, before I hit the decks I wanted and was able, got lucky in one game, and I'm happy I won. That puts a lot of confidence in me.
You got lucky in one game, so the two other games you beat Silent Storm was all skill, right?
Wasn't trying to say that, but I guess.
I can read between the lines. I also see that you're holding a Hogger plushie. These are courtesy of Blizzard, who'd visit us today. In fact, we got some of the community people here, some of the balanced design people, because Blizzard is in Irvine, California, which is only about an hour and a half drive, I believe, unless you hit traffic, in which case they started yesterday and they just got here. That's why they didn't show up. How do you like these plushies here, PhoneTap?
They're pretty awesome. I'm glad I got my own. It's awesome.
You know that the collar is removable, too. It's not just for show. It's actually like armor you can disrobe. You just disrobed him! How is he going to stop all the Dr. Booms and stuff now? All right. There you go. So, how have you been enjoying yourself, PhoneTap? This is your first offline tournament performance, correct?
Yes, this is my first time. It's amazing. I've met a lot of great people. I'm a very soft-spoken guy, but like I love listening to everybody talk. Like, I'm learning a lot, and this... it's been a dream come true, basically.
How old are you, if I may ask?
19.
Oh, wow, 19. So you're still a university student, right?
Yes, I just finished my freshman year of college.
Gotcha. And I think some people around you might be really bad influences, me included. I didn't actually finish my university. But you're doing it, and you're still playing Hearthstone. How's the balance between those two parts of your life?
I'm pretty addicted to Hearthstone, so it definitely can get in the way of my schoolwork, but I try my best, and because school's pretty important.
Well, I think Blizzard's giving you a thumbs up, but your parents are definitely giving you a thumbs down. But I guess if you're winning some money here this weekend, who can be really mad at that? What's your realistic goal going to this tournament? You've already won your first series. I believe Life Coach also won his first series 3-0, so you'll be playing against Life Coach coming up as soon as Group C is over. Do you feel really confident going up against a player of that caliber? He just won the Viagame House Cup.
I'm definitely aware of Life Coach's accomplishments. I want to feel confident and hope I have a chance, and we'll see what happens.
One step at a time, for sure. Well, thank you so much, PhoneTap, for stopping by. I don't want to take too much away from the broadcast because we are here to continue to see the series between Ostkaka and Reynad. So let's hop on over back with Izumo, Chalky, and Domdus for the continuation of this match.
Thank you very much, Dan. And it's always good to meet some of these new players. PhoneTap's actually one of the most successful online players, and a lot of people that have played in a lot of the ESL tournaments give credit to PhoneTap when they win. So players like Kabi is a part of that under-the-radar practice group said PhoneTap was an instrumental part in their victory, so it's cool to hear from him.
Yeah, PhoneTap was actually the player I played last in the Last Chance Open, and I barely squeaked out a victory to qualify for this, and then he, of course, also made it. So I have a lot of respect for him. He's a great player.
Yeah, it's awesome seeing a lot of these new players that have been trying to get here online for so long, and they finally got a chance, made it to this land, and you can really just see a lot of new players so happy just to be at their first event.
Yeah.
Pretty awesome.
Yeah. Well, we almost have the tech issues resolved. I think we just had to switch out one of the players' computers, so we should be jumping into the match between Reynad and Ostkaka here very shortly. It's 1-0 in favor of Ostkaka, I believe, at this point.
Yeah, Pretty unfortunate for Ostkaka, the remake then. Mm. Don't know if he'll be able to draw double backstab again.
Right.
Yeah. In the SI.
Also, subtract that Misha roll. It doesn't count anymore.
Nope.
No.
It's no longer an official match.
Okay.
Wrecked.
And I was going to show my card, but there's secret notes on here. Oh. So you can't see the tallies as well.
Secret.
All my complaints about Chalky. Nope.
Oh, it says Druid. Spoilers.
All right, well, let's take a look at the bracket so far from what we've seen from Group C while we're waiting to jump into that match. How we got here. So Roger took out Reynad 3-1 at the first series of the day. Double O's took out Ostkaka 3-1 as well. And then, of course, in the winner's match, we saw Roger being the first player from Group C to qualify for the playoff stage tomorrow. And, of course, we're waiting for the results of Reynad versus Ostkaka. The loser will be out of the tournament, and they'll have to sit around the studio in shame for the next 2 days, hanging their heads, hey, realizing that they were one of the first players eliminated.
It's not that bad.
No, it's not that bad.
It sounded very sad.
Very sad, yeah. Yeah. It's a fun time here. We got a lot of players. Players have been competing against Dan. He's been giving away packs to players that can beat him. Of course, Dan said we got some of the Blizzard people in the house as well.
Oh, yeah.
Enjoying some Hearthstone.
It's like a awesome vacation, you know, get to spend your time in California.
You can just enjoy your time here.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Playing's nice, but it's also a nice environment.
So where are you from, Chalky?
I am from good old Indiana.
Indiana?
Yeah.
Sure, there's a lot of people that are watching the stream right now that are also from Indiana. Is there anything that you'd like to say to your fellow Indianans?
Get some shout-outs.
I think they'd call
them.
Themselves, like, Hoosiers, probably.
Sure. Shit. That's something that I wouldn't know, because I'm not from Indiana.
Yeah, there's probably some people watching, like, woo, Indiana. Yeah.
That's your shout-out? To the woo, Indiana?
I don't know. It's not as bad as people say. Pretty nice state. No complaints. Mm-hmm.
Dominus, you're from pretty local. You're from Irvine, right?
I'm from Irvine, where Blizzard is. So, yeah, I love it. I was born and raised in Southern California. Great place, definitely. And close to everything, so it's nice. I drove here. Didn't have to fly. It was a nice little perk. Well,
yeah,
nice.
So I was like, woo!
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, it looks like we're having a little bit more issues than we thought with the tech. So we're going to take a quick commercial break while we wait to jump in and finish the match between Reynad and Ostkaka. But don't go anywhere. More Season 2 Finals for the Hearthstone Legendary Series returns right after this. The Season 2 Finals of the Hearthstone Legendary Series. Once again, I'm Osmo Kitty, joined by Chalky and Dom Dis. We just had some short technical difficulties in the losers match of Reynad versus Ostkaka, but we've got those resolved. We can get on with the day. We can finish out Group C.
Yeah, let's find out who the loser is.
Who
cares about the winner, but the loser.
Yeah, right now Ostkaka has a 1-0 lead in the series over Reynad. But it's still anybody's game. 1-0 is not that big of a deal. We've seen lots of people come back from that deficit so far.
Definitely. Mm-hmm.
And they are fighting to play against Doublos, who is waiting the winner in the deciding match. Mm-hmm.
Exciting stuff.
It's sort of intimidating for Doublos.
No, he's sitting over there. He's doing fine.
He's sitting pretty.
No, he's just talking.
Enjoying himself.
I'm looking him right in the eye right now. He is terrified.
He's quivering in his boots.
Yeah.
He's literally just sitting there conversing.
Okay.
He doesn't. All right. He's oblivious. That's great.
Yeah. Alrighty, well, we're in to game number two. Reynad's going to queue up the Hunter. This is a rematch from what we were watching. We were about four turns or something in the Hunter versus Rogue matchup last time when we ran into the tech issues. So
yeah,
Reynad is once again on the Hunter, Ostkaka on the Rogue, and actually pretty similar hand from last time.
Yeah, there's the double backstab.
Double backstab. You got the oil as well. The
he
deadly.
He just needs Edwin and Si now.
Yeah.
And it's like the remake never happened.
Exactly. Except, this is a similar hand for Reynad as well. What the
killed
heck?
The man, knife
Reynad's
juggler.
Hand's a bit better.
Yeah.
He got the scientist and the bow, which is pretty important against Rogue. But
I have crossed off the Misha roll on my statistics, as you guys can see.
Yeah, that's the reason we regamed. Couldn't have another Misha.
Yeah.
They actually, I'm getting word they fixed the animal companion bug.
All right, so it should be getting closer to 30%. Oh, 33%. Okay, I got you.
Yeah, there was no bug, TJ. Sorry.
It's all in your head.
Oh, here we go.
Here we go.
Whoa! Oh, it's Misha!
No!
Oh, no!
conspiracy theories popping up everywhere.
Oh my gosh.
I just unmarked my mark next to Misha.
I was confused by that statement, but I think I know where you're going.
Yep.
Okay. So, how many Mishas is that, TJ?
Eight. Eight Mishas, one Huffer, two Leox. That's the breakdown.
Never lucky.
So we talked a little bit earlier about this matchup, and we came to the conclusion that the slower the Hunter is, the better off the Rogue is. So Chalky made the point that Rogues sort of are very board-centric, so the less the Hunter focuses on the board, the better position the Rogue is.
Yeah, especially with stuff like Bow, really. You know, Bow can be up to 9, maybe even 12 damage, depending on how many traps you proc. That's, you know, a lot of damage. And Ostkaka has a heal bot now, which is pretty nice. Ideally, I think he actually wants to play it next turn, because then you can freezing trap it.
Ooh, that too.
Which is really good. It'll probably get bowed off, but what can he do? He's actually just going to do it for 4. That's how much he wants to freezing trap this.
Yep.
And just kind of seize the board early. He does have a prep oil.
Plays right into Bow.
And there's the other Misha.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So you're on my side now.
Well, I mean, according to your stats, it's 80% Misha around there.
Slightly under, but very
close.
I'll
give you 50-50 odds on Misha.
8 out of 11.
We'll just make a bet right now. I get Leok and Huffer, you get Misha.
That's
one Hearthstone card back.
Okay. Gotcha. Bet's on.
The bet is on.
And it's total throughout the day, right? So I already have a huge head start.
No, it's right now. Oh. Right here, right now. This animal companion will hit the board.
Okay. Oh, so only one animal companion.
One companion.
Okay. A card back?
No, a card pack.
Oh, a pack. Okay, yeah. One single card pack.
One card pack that we could probably get anyway
if
we wanted one.
High stakes, guys. High stakes.
Yeah. There's card pack codes floating around.
Yeah, they're just all over here. Here we go. I mean, no, these stakes are huge.
They're huge. Yeah. Whoa, did he say one card pack?
It's huge for me. I need to get me that Toshley.
Did he say one?
What?
Wow, we do see a big game hunter attack in the rogue.
That's not going to be that helpful.
Yeah. Did Reyna top out at... Have we seen if he topped out at Dr. Boom?
Actually, I'm not sure.
We have no idea, but I would assume so.
Okay.
Then it'll be helpful, definitely.
Rag, maybe, but probably not.
Oh, no.
Here we go.
Yeah!
It's lucky! What? Come on!
Never lucky. Or always lucky for TJ.
Wow. I will be waiting after this matchup for my pack.
Yes, and the winner is TJ.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Rigged.
Chucky and I were actually playing also the random deck battle.
The random deck.
I'm surprised
the
you brought that up.
The autofill deck.
Crushed.
I beg to differ.
3-0.
We had to go to rehearsal, and so Chalky ran over to my computer and conceded on my keyboard. So he was disqualified. So I actually won that one also.
All right, TJ. Whatever you say.
Second place in Misha contests. Second place in random decks.
Well,
yeah,
back to this game. Both players' hands
moving along from that
are pretty awkward.
Yeah.
Like, what are you going to do? Unleash the Hound.
Unleash the Hound.
You can unleash the Hound, or Hunter's Mark, unleash the Hound to take out this.
I mean,
50-50. Or just that.
Do you pass? Do you hero power?
Huh. Unleash the Hound doesn't really get that great against Rogue ever.
Neither does Big Game Hunter against Hunter.
It's true. Wonder.
Maybe Ostkaka's sitting there. He's like, I hope he has Dr. Boom. Probably not. Well, that's unlucky for Ostkaka because now the Hound gets to live.
Well, with empty hands like this, Reynad actually has the advantage just because he's going to put him on a clock. He's going to do 2 damage every turn. But Ostkaka has more tools to draw into extra stuff. He draws into a sprint, all of a sudden, yeah. It's a completely different game.
See, normally Shredder's good, but not really. I've got the beast. He's freezing trap. He's going to kill off the Juggler, though, so we might see a bow attack into the 4-2. Might see a kill command or something.
Dumb
decision. And there,
it is. There comes the boo.
Right after the big game hunt. How poetic.
That sucks.
Wow. Well, obviously, you let him freezing trap the Dr. Boom out of pity, right? Or you let him freezing trap the big game hunter. Reynad's going to say no.
No pity at all. This man's a cold-blooded killer.
And... Phantom Knives is okay if he has a second big game hunter in this rogue deck.
That would be glorious.
Well, you know.
What do I know?
Handlocks are pretty popular nowadays.
True.
So,
sure.
But double big game hunter is not something that you see in rogue. Maybe like in other handlocks or control warrior or perhaps even druid if it's really handlock heavy field.
Okay. I have a plan.
All right.
You fan of knives into Kazan Mystic.
Yep.
The place.
Yeah. Don't even think that'd even be... Oh, no.
Oh, that'd
be
sick.
Really
yeah,
good.
Yeah.
That'd be really good.
Okay, no. Oh. Probably wanted to get, like, Bluegill Warrior off of this just to proc that trap. Mm-hmm. But at this point, not a good spot.
Yeah.
Just gonna pass, wanting to draw probably like Flurry next turn. Maybe I can go to 6.
This is one of the weaknesses of Rogue, is sometimes they just get inconsistent draws.
Yep.
And we've talked about that throughout the day. That seems to be the downfall of the third deck. The infamous third deck. And Ostkaka is just going to go ahead and concede. So, series is still tied 1-1. Still anybody's game. But that was a really rough match for Ostkaka.
Reynad looks slightly amused by the victory.
Mm. Yeah. Oskaka's had 2 regames. Kind of unlucky in that regard. And lost them both in dominating fashion. Yep. Like, just didn't have a chance in either of the regames. So,
and how does that play in...
That plays awfully into your mental state.
Definitely.
Yeah.
He's not happy.
Nope.
Domnus, you're sort of primarily an online tournament player. This is your first LAN performance.
This is my first LAN performance.
Have you ever suffered from like a disconnect in a big match?
No, I don't think so. I mean, these are my first really big matches, and luckily it hasn't happened. So yesterday was pretty tech trouble-free.
Mm. Yeah. That's good. Probably a good thing. I didn't even notice that thing was there. It really scared me. I looked down at our feed and I was like, oh my
Hugger,
god, there's something
gotcha.
On Chalky.
It's the spooky.
It is spooky.
Oh, next matchup is going to be the Tempo Mage from Reynad. Going to give that one another shot versus the
Handlock. I feel like this might be the matchup you wanted, though. Blade Flurry really wrecks the Tempo Mage, especially with no like counterspell or anything.
Definitely.
So, maybe getting Handlock here, pretty good for Reynad as far as matchup.
You clear the board once, and it's pretty much
over.
Yeah, and Ostkaka should know that there's no counterspell in this deck. So, doesn't have to care about that. I remember earlier, Roger actually tested for it with the coin.
Right.
But we did see 2 Mad Scientists out in a previous match. You asked for it. Only one of them resolved. So there's only Mirror Entity.
Well, pretty poor hands for both players. Reynad thinks about keeping the Mirror Entity, but usually that's not a great card to have in the opening against Handlock, because a lot of times they can just throw down an Ancient Watcher.
Yeah, I don't think he actually considered keeping it, I think.
He clicked it twice.
He just didn't want to be the one to mulligan first.
Yeah.
Well, he got a good opener.
Yeah.
A really good opener.
This is really nice.
Yeah, this is like all you can really ask for is Manaworm, Coin Manaworm. I've heard some people call Tempo Mage the Manaworm deck because it's so different starting with Manaworm versus not starting with Manaworm.
Mm-hmm.
And starting with 2 of them has to be like the best thing ever.
He chooses to go with the 2-1 though instead of the second Manaworm.
So I think he's doing this because if Ostkaka is to Mortal Coil on this turn, it's awkward because he can't tap as well.
Right, he won't be able to get that Mountain Giant on 4.
So this pushes 2 damage instead of 1, which is just a very small optimization of damage because he's not going to be playing any more spells.
Yeah.
Right.
So he just maximizes his damage, looking to burn him out with that Fireball probably. So I like that play from Reynad.
So Didn't Stick usually runs the 1-up Clockwork Gnome. Reynad, from watching him, he seems to favor like full-on.
Yeah, he's definitely token, so he in runs favor of consistency.
Double. Yeah, so he usually runs double of that, but most of the lists that I've seen that are similar to this run, one just the double Mechanical Yeti and 1 Clockwork Gnome.
Right.
But there's a little bit of wiggle room there. Having an early curve is really important, as we talked about. So sometimes putting in the extra Clockwork Gnome can give you better matchup scenarios where you wouldn't.
Yeah, I can see that. Like, it's a pretty weak card on its own. So, like, late game, you really don't want to be drawing into it 1 mana, 2/1. But it does maximize your early game consistency, which is, I know it's a huge thing that Reynad emphasizes in his deck building is, you know, usually if you want 1 copy of a card, you probably want 2 copies. It has to be a very specific case where you only want 1 copy.
Yeah. Dominus, you're a big player of Paladin, which is a class that's known for a lot of one-ofs.
Mm.
Do you think that that's a big disadvantage to run a lot of one-ofs because it reduces the consistency of the deck?
I guess it depends on like the meta and like what kind of format you're playing in. So in a tournament setting or like on ladder, for example, it's really good to have a lot of consistency, right? Because you're just playing against random things all the time. Mm. So that definitely could be a little disadvantage. But if, you know, in a tournament setting like this, where, you know, you can expect certain things,
yeah,
you could definitely gear yourself towards it and run some one-ofs. Mm.
Like the Cog Hammer?
Like the Cog Hammer. Cog Hammer's just awesome, too, all around.
Yeah.
It's value. 3 yeah. mana. Taunt value. Divine Shield.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Well, right now, Reynad actually has 13 damage maximum. So, there is a chance Ostkaka just dies next turn. And that just... Nope. Okay. Thought maybe he'd go for the Molten.
Yeah.
And then he would be dead.
I think he realizes the potential, though.
Right. Yeah, any spare part plus Fireball would be exactly 13.
And you... I would hope he would know that he would that Reynad has a spare part.
Right, yeah. But it might be hard to factor in that with both the Sorcerer's Apprentice and the Mana Worm,
yeah,
spare parts turn into 0 mana, deal 1 damage.
Yeah.
You might be thinking of just Fireball. Mm. And Reynad not going to play around Moltens. I like that. There is a Molten, so it's a little unfortunate for him, but can't really...
You can't afford
you can't
to play
keep respecting it, yeah. In his earlier match, I thought Reynad played a little too defensively with the mage deck against Handlock, mm-hmm. like fireballing an Ancient Watcher.
Yeah.
And in this match, you can definitely see he was much more willing to take an aggressive line. He has a lot of burn right now. That's 9 from hand, and that would be 4 on board, so he'd do 13 again. Not quite enough. So you might see something like an Emperor here, and with Archmage, a spare part, and a Frostbolt, that's pretty crazy.
Yeah.
It's one of the worst spare parts that you can get for Archmage Titanized, though, because if you're playing it on an empty board, it loses you tempo, because you're trading Archmage Titanized being on the board for a Fireball.
Sometimes that can be okay
against
Handlock if you plan to use it later. Just maximize the Fireballs, but yeah, usually it's pretty poor. But a second Healbot is in Ostkaka's hand. He can just, like, play another giant. He's not really at risk of dying quite yet.
He can watch her Shadowflame, but he'd have to trade in the anti-Healbot as well.
Yeah, I don't like that as much as just trading and then playing the other giant.
Yep.
Because that develops more power.
Yeah.
And saves your Healbot. Kind of.
Yeah.
It's a 3-1, which is weak, but
You do leave your Tana.
I guess he's just going to Tana. Yeah.
No. You do leave your Molten Giant at 3 health, but if you're forcing the Temple Mage to throw burn at your creatures,
exactly. Yeah.
That's less burn that you have to worry about later on when you get to the points of, am I dead?
Yep.
Yep. And Sorcerer's Apprentice going to reduce mana cost a lot. Not really lethal yet.
Not quite.
Yeah.
There's like those one-turn kill videos where they get just a bunch of
crazy
Sorcerer's Apprentice
stuff
on the board and
yep.
throw down the Archmage Antinitis and have an endless slew of fireballs.
Yeah, we're not quite there, you know.
No.
Three more Sorcerer's Apprentice.
Yeah. Unstable Portal. There's a potential for another one.
Well, this was once upon a time regarded as the best card in the game by Reynad, I think.
Yeah. The Unstable Portal.
The best card in the game, unless I'm
ooh,
using it and I don't get something
skill
good.
Shot.
Yeah, really nailed that.
He doesn't want to use too many of his spells here because he has Archmage, so
right.
He wants to save at least one of the cheap spells to be able to use with it.
Yeah, but I think he can just portal, probably.
I think so.
All right.
If your apprentice lives, you can fireball anyway.
Esports! Whoa!
That's bad.
It's
really bad. He's got a BGH.
Good.
Unless he plays the BGH as a 4-2. So
I don't think he can afford to do that. You know this deck runs at least Dr. Boom, sometimes even Rag.
Right.
Yeah. I wouldn't BGH if I were Ostkaka, but who knows? Maybe Force Tank Max is going to get in there for 7.
So what surprised me was we actually didn't see any Rags yesterday in Group A and B.
Well,
really?
We might see one right now.
Here we go.
That's it. Yeah, he's just going to start clocking him. Just going to deal 8. Decides he doesn't need to heal, which is correct. 16 is really safe.
Mirror Image actually is fantastic against Rag. As long as he dodges AoE.
Yeah. Which, there is AoE, so. But with Archmage, it's actually one of the best draws in his deck.
Yep.
And I believe the tokens cost 0.
Yeah, they do.
So you can. Wow, that might have been the best draw in his deck.
Very nice.
I'd Frostbolt Face, probably. You don't need to, but I like it.
What do you. Why wouldn't you? I mean, it does only cost 1 mana, but.
I mean, at this point, it's almost obvious that you have something, and it's probably Frostbolt.
Yeah.
So you probably should do it. If you weren't going to do it, you would just instantly in turn to make it seem like you don't have a Frostbolt.
Mm-hmm.
This does set up lethal, is why you should do it.
Right.
Because 3 mana fireball, 4 mana fireball ping is exactly 13. And Ostkaka might not play around that. He does heal up, though. Wow.
Ouch.
Having a
goes for the most offensive play possible, and you know, I don't actually like that.
That's pretty brutal.
It is brutal.
So you know your opponent has 3 fireballs, and he hasn't played any from his deck. So if he draws a fireball from his deck, that's 24 damage. You have to heal at least 4, which is 1 above what Earthen Ring and Siphon heal for. You've already used both heal bots. So you need to basically draw Lotheb and clock your opponent not somehow. I might have gone for the 50-50 rag shot there. Just Shadow Flame the either Ancient Watcher or the Healbot. Gone for the 50-50 shot and kept the 8-8 on the board. But Ostkaka took a really safe line, but if he doesn't have a way to out-heal these fireballs, he'll just lose no matter what.
So it's 24 damage over the next 2 turns. He's got to find a way to block some of it. Then on top of that, he has to deal with whatever Reynad's going to draw in between.
Yeah, if I were Reynad here, the one thing I definitely wouldn't do is play that Force Tank Max. You know Ostkaka plays 2 big games.
Right.
It might seem tempting. There's a taunt out there anyway.
But.
Oh, no.
And here it comes.
5 mana, 7-7. With Divine Shield.
So much value.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he's going to, like, kind of... I mean, he goes half in, which I don't like at all. But we might see a tap from Ostkaka. No, we can't see a tap from Ostkaka. That would kill him.
Yeah. He knows.
So wait a second. 3. He goes to 16. Now, Oskaka's going to be one off setting up lethal this turn. Or he can set up lethal with the Sun Fury. So Ostkaka can wipe the board,
so
develop a Molten, and play Sun Fury.
With the BGH.
And that is 17 on the board. And his opponent will be at 16.
Yep.
And Reynad has no way to win immediately, so he's going to have to fireball minions.
Wow.
And I think playing the 4-stank max might cost Reynad this game.
Might, yeah, if you just double fireball faced.
He needs Frostbolt.
Yes.
Exactly. No.
Well, now he's going to start fireballing minions. And, he's got to throw fireball into, like,
he has to throw fireball into like a 4-2 or a 3-3. Or double fireball an 8-8.
I don't think he can afford to double fireball
no
an 8-8.
No matter what he fireballs, Ostkaka is going to play another 8-8 and just win. Reynad has no way to win now. Force Tank Max actually costing him the game off that unstable portal.
The best card in the game.
According lost to Reynad. Oh, man. Yeah,
I think he just has to fireball one minion, then fireball face, and hope to top deck either his other fireball that he has not used yet, or maybe a Frostbolt.
His natural fireball.
Yeah,
natural
he has fireball. To draw his natural fireball or natural Frostbolt.
Yep, that's, I think, the only way. I'm sure he'll come to that.
Or unstable portal into something ridiculous.
And like a Deathwing.
Deathwing!
There we go.
What a weird game.
Yeah. And he might even just mirror an entity.
I don't think that does anything. In fact, I don't think that the zombie
probably
gel.
Won't do anything, but
So he's going to go for the play we thought. I actually don't like mirror entity here because of zombie chow. He probably doesn't. I know he probably doesn't play it, but
you looked at these players' hands like 5 turns ago. And you think, wow, Reynad's in
Reynad's
dominating
got
position.
Oh,
he's got Archmage Antonitis with cheap spells from Emperor Thorasan. He's got Sorcerer's Apprentice on the board. He's able to sort of fill his hand with fireballs. You're thinking, how could he lose this?
He has a 2-outer to win. But, it's just pretty crazy. Like,
I wonder how many cards he has left. Get some odds here.
Like, you saw your opponent use both Healbots.
Mm. Right.
And you have 4 fireballs. You're not going to have that much burn. Your opponent had a taunt up anyway to like block your force tank back.
Yeah.
I don't see why you wouldn't just double fireball their face and make them have like Lotheb or something. I'm a little surprised he's even going to play anything.
Yeah.
Maybe going to make sure it's not ice block.
That seems a little bit far-fetched.
That's ambitious.
Yeah.
And he's going to go all face anyway. I don't think that really matters.
All right, puts him at 3.
Here we
go. Reynad
needs to be a burn spell off the top.
On a draw to win.
On the draw.
No.
Drum roll. Nope. That's rough.
Yep.
Swing and a miss.
Yeah, I mean...
Time to fireball my face.
And now we're back into that spot
where...
where what?
You just kind of...
Where Reynad loses?
Well, you're still in the match.
Yeah.
And you kind of just costed yourself the game, right? Like, you know, joke about never lucky and all that, but that was a player decision, your decision that cost you the game, and it's...
It definitely stings more
than
never lucky.
Yeah, it stings a lot more than never lucky, right? Like, it's pretty easy to shake off. You know, I got unlucky, which is what happened game 1. He got the Grom off the top.
Right.
But game 3, you know, it's like, could I have won that game? Probably.
And the Tempo Mage continues to be a liability for Reynad.
Yeah. I don't think he's won a match yet, right? With it, right? Yeah.
No. Well, he's only won 2 matches so far the whole day.
That's true.
That was with the 2 good decks, I guess you can call them.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah.
So
it was with Hunter only, right?
Did he not win one with Patron Warrior?
I don't know. Maybe he did.
Yeah. Well, He's on the ropes now. He has to win two in a row in order to take this series. Ostkaka is one win away from securing a spot in that top eight.
But it's got to be the ropes.
Or no, no. He's one win away from securing a spot in the match against Double Os. So he still has to play one more even if he wins. Reynad, yeah. If Reynad loses this match, he is out of the tournament. He would have played two matches, be one of the first players eliminated.
It's a disappointing finish for him, I think.
Definitely.
You probably come in expecting more. I know, you know, he's not that beat up if he loses. He's not that excited if he wins, but you still really don't want to go 0-2.
And you're still always a little bit happy when you win, right?
Right.
Even when you're Reynad.
Even when you're Reynad.
You asked for it. Yeah.
There's unstable portal. I think we get some more esports.
Yeah. Finally, we see the mechanical Yetis. This is actually the first time today that we've even seen them.
They are in that deck.
Yeah. So, an okay hand. He doesn't have any of those one or two drops that he really wanted. Does that bad scientist. No Mana Worm. No Clockwork Gnome. That makes
there
it a little bit better.
Go.
Yeah. Right. 2-1 going first is really what you want against Rogue.
Yep.
They hate to coin the dagger up here. And I know Ostkaka almost never does, so.
Oh.
Wait a second.
It's time for the Raid Leader. That damage.
Well, rip Raid Leader.
Yep.
No.
Having the coin as the rogue is a pretty big deal.
Definitely.
Well, Ostkaka's had it every time as rogue.
No, not in the remake.
Still yet. Yeah, in the remake, too.
No, in the game before. Sorry, the game before the remake.
No, he had it then, too.
Did he?
Yeah.
Whoa. It's a true sign of a good rogue player.
I'm almost as good at counting coins as I am counting Mishas.
I don't know, maybe he did. I'm just playing it off like he did, PJ. Just sound confident, and people will believe you.
Exactly.
Somebody's going to go back from the VOD. No, he didn't.
Yeah. If you say it with enough confidence, eventually it becomes true.
Eight Mishas.
Eight? 16?
16?
Oh, okay. Well, he's taken 4 damage so far. That's not a lot. So.
He's looking pretty good, and he curves out.
Yeah.
That's a really great draw, though.
He's happy about that, definitely.
Oh, for sure.
With the Flame Waker in hand?
Yep. Flame Waker probably going to finally get value this game.
First time I think all of his matches as Tempo Mage, actually.
I remember the day that Reynad found out that you actually can't stealth the Flame Waker. Because you use the finicky cloak field.
You
and
can right. stealth him for a very short duration.
And he's just like, no.
He unstealths himself instantly in order to throw those fireballs.
So Tempo Mage has become Face Mage. And with 2 fireballs, I really like this play. Mm-hmm. Reynad has realized his mistakes of the past of not going face and not fireballing face. It looks like he's ready to fireball face finally.
Think you utilize a sap here?
I mean, just draking here is pretty weak unless you top deck something like a prep. So you almost have to. And the BGH is just like he really needs to just fight for board.
It also denies the spare part as well, or the potential spare part
right.
from the mechanical Yeti. So it makes it so the Flame Waker all of a sudden becomes slightly weaker. See if he gets off the Flame Cannon.
Oh, little unlucky. But still okay.
Too bad.
Yeah.
How much heal have we seen from Ostkaka's rogue deck? Have we seen Earthring Farseers or anti-kill bots?
We've definitely seen an anti-kill bot.
Yes, okay. Definitely.
I want to say there's a Farseer, but he does have a BGH in there, which is... You have to cut something for that.
Yep.
But a lot of rogues tend to like having one Earthring Farseer.
So many options.
Dominus, you play rogue?
Play a little bit of it. Not as much as some, but it's a fun class. Enjoy it.
Do you own Trade Prince Gallywix?
I do not, actually.
Oh, man.
I'm missing out on all the fun. That's what happens when I'm free to play, and I just... I've only come back playing again recently, so I need to get a lot of the new cards.
You're an ambassador for all the free-to-play players out
right.
there.
Right, exactly.
if you're playing Hearthstone out there and you're a free-to-play player, you can make it to the big stage,
yep,
too.
Yep, definitely. Mm. You don't need all the cards.
Yeah.
Nothing like that. You don't need all these pure golden decks like Reynad's got. No. Someday I'll be just be...
Double O's had some golden decks, too.
Oh, yeah.
Does Double O's have all golden decks? Give me a thumbs up or thumbs down, Double O's. Three full golden decks Double O's has.
Getting a little bit of clap. But back to the game. Reynad acts like he has a decision. And I mean that's gonna do it.
Yeah.
He fakes, you know, the whole no, I definitely don't have double fireball. Mm. You're fine. Play that Azure Drake. He had no option though, so I think if Ostkaka had a heal, he would have played it.
Yep.
No heal.
He's done it.
That's it. Tempo Mage takes a game.
He has done it.
Reynad can breathe a sigh of relief as the second fireball targets the face. And we have a tied series. We're going to a game number 5. The loser's match of Group C comes down to the next game. It is going to be, I believe, the Patron Warrior from Reynad versus the Oil Rogue from Ostkaka.
Yep.
It's all on the line for these players. They lose, they're out.
Yeah.
High pressure situation.
Very.
Who has the edge in this matchup? Actually, do not know.
Oh man, all eyes on me.
Yep. Giving you the stare.
I've heard a lot of mixed opinions on this matchup.
Okay.
I remember a lot of people thought Rogue initially. Then the play style of the Patron kind of changed to try to build up all your combo pieces and OTK them.
Yeah.
But I think the Rogue's still pretty favored, and Ostkaka definitely knows what he's doing. He rates the matchup, you know, around 55% for the Rogue. And if Reynad has practiced Patron, you know, as little as he says he has, then maybe Ostkaka's at a bit of an advantage. But still definitely a very close matchup. Either player could take this.
And speaking of high-pressure situations, Chalky, do you own Trade Prince Galliwix?
How's this a high-pressure situation?
You don't know my follow-up question yet.
I do.
What? What does Trade Prince Galliwix say when he enters the board?
Hey, pal, Trade Prince Galliwix here.
I actually don't know.
I couldn't confirm if that is correct or not either. I was about to say.
I was expecting you to not know. I am
100% confident in that answer.
Okay, fair enough. I just know there's like some weird music.
Yeah. There's some weird
music. Yeah, it's got music.
Mm-hmm, it does. Can confirm. All right. Chalky, cast well under pressure.
Here we go. Last game. We're going to have a loser after this.
Mm-hmm. Somebody's going to be walking out of that booth really sad.
And one of them with rekindled spirits.
Mm-hmm. I'm excited to see Reynad's play here with this deck. Actually, he's always said that he has never practiced it, but the person that he beat when he had played it for the first time was me.
Yeah.
And he beat me twice.
Yeah.
So I take offense to it. It makes me sad.
Dominus is like, yeah, Reynad is the best Patron Warrior player I've
no
ever
doubt
seen.
He will win this.
Mm-hmm. Well, Reynad 3-capped, Ostkaka no keeps. Mm-hmm. So if that's any indication, Reynad's happy with his hand. Ostkaka not so much. Got pretty weak cards off the mulligan as well. Really looking to get some draw cards going.
Yeah, that's pretty rough.
Yeah, I think he'd really like to have something like a prep sprint. And he's even going to dagger face, realizing next turn he probably has to re-dagger.
Even just like some kind of creature, like a pile of treasure, something to play before Azure Drake on turn 5. Would be make his hand worlds better.
Piloted Treaders are really good against Patron. Bloodmage Thalnos, not so much. He could go for a 3 damage backstab and clear the Armorsmith.
You can take out the end part of the last sentence. Piloted Treaders are really good.
That's true.
Period.
So, yeah, he's going to go ahead and clear the Armorsmith. Makes sense. You don't really get value from Blood Mage Thalnos otherwise. It becomes a liability late game. You really want to cycle it ASAP.
Yep.
But it's going to get challenged by an Acolyte of Pain. And he might have to eviscerate that. Unless he draws something like a deadly poison. Nope. Two saps. Very weak cards in this matchup.
So in playing this matchup a few times, actually quite a bit of times, I've realized that there's a couple win conditions. One is just doing patron things and killing them. Two is to sort of put on enough pressure early to where the rogue just runs out of damage. Sometimes if they don't draw into their big AoE spells, if you put out a reasonably sized board early on, they're forced to throw eviscerates and like dagger charges or oil charges into things earlier on. Sometimes they can just run out of damage. It's similar to like Control Warrior. Sometimes right. Control Warrior can just outpace them, and eventually they have like five cards left, and even if they piece together all the damage they have left, they just can't win.
Yeah, it looks like Ostkaka is actually really aware of that potentially being a problem and decides to save Eviscerate and just throw out a sap.
Yeah.
This denies a card, kind of sets Reynad behind in tempo. He realizes sap really doesn't have a great application in this matchup. Like,
it's pretty much only to like a really fat frothing berserker or something like
yeah,
that, right?
Yeah, which basically they save until they can charge them out right. and kill you.
Yeah. P-H-A-T fat.
Mm-hmm.
A. All right. Well, you might consider axing off the 1-1 here. It sucks to play a loot hoarder since it just dies to the dagger. But maybe you just, yeah. I think what Reynad's thinking here, he also played the incorrect acolyte. I doubt Ostkaka picked up on that, but he played the non-sapped one. This actually is a bit of an issue for Ostkaka. He sensed out that if he had to sap my acolyte, he definitely doesn't have backstab number two. He definitely doesn't have a deadly poison. Like, he has no good answers, so I should just get these extra draws. And the draws are pretty relevant. One card Reynad's really looking for is Emperor Thorison. To reduce down Warsong Commander, some Whirlwind effects, Frothing Berserkers, which he has one of already.
Yeah.
And just go for a huge OTK turn.
Yep. If you're reducing like two pieces of the combo, you're in a really great spot.
Yeah, it's already pretty huge.
Even if you're reducing Battle Rage in a piece of the combo, it allows you to refill your hand a lot easier because weaving in Battle Rage for one mana is actually a pretty big deal.
Yeah, so now he already has two pieces of the combo, really looking for Warsong and maybe another Frothing and a Deathbite, and I mean, that's pretty much already lethal if he can piece together those cards. Which sounds like a lot, but I mean, two-fifths of the way there, this deck plays a ton of draw.
Yep.
Got an Acolyte on the board.
Acolyte in hand. Battle Rage in hand.
Yep. It just gets more and more ridiculous, and so Ostkaka is basically on a clock to kill Reynad. And Reynad's even playing some defensive cards like Sludge Belcher in his list.
This has got to feel pretty rough for Ostkaka. I mean, he doesn't have all of the clairvoyance that we do, not being able to see both hands, but we've seen Reynad sort of give a game away to Ostkaka, and Ostkaka is still on the verge of what looks to be a pretty rough game number five. It might be knocked out of the tournament by that. It's got to be a little bit frustrating.
Yeah.
At least he's got a prep sprint going for him.
I'm really curious. Wait.
He's going
to... Okay, so he's going to expend a lot of cards just to make sure. He's going to go for a clear early and draw a lot. So he's cycling a lot, keeping his hands low enough so that he won't overdraw. This turns out to be pretty solid. It looked sketchy at first because he was roping and kind of worried he would overdraw, but gets it all off in the correct order. There's Ostkaka's board. And now we'll have to see how Ostkaka kind of deals with that. Because Reynad's been drawing a lot, and as the rogue player, the more they draw, the more scared you get. You're pretty scared of Emperor next turn already.
I wonder.
Especially if you don't develop a board. Right. And right now with this hand, it's looking like prep sprint is going to be the play. There's no clean ways to deal with these acolytes. It's so just weird.
Yep.
Yeah, they don't do too much besides kind of enable execute, which is a problem for a big Edwin.
Yeah.
So
but
many options.
You're right. It's awkward to clear unless you want to like SI one, but then you'd have to use your prep somehow, and how you use prep. So it's gonna sap one.
This guy's toast.
And it looks like he really values his dagger. Just really wants to save that at two charges rather than valuing the damage.
No.
He makes an 8-8.
He made an 8-8!
But Reynad has Big Game Hunter.
Oh. Stakes were made.
Mistakes.
Panic turn.
Oops. Yeah.
Oops. Well, okay, so to be fair, I even said this earlier. I said Reynad probably wasn't, it wasn't likely he was going to switch up his deck from when he qualified with the Paging Warrior. And he actually did. It's nearly the same deck, but he put in a BGH.
Well, I'd say it is pretty likely that he would switch up. I mean, Reynad's the type of guy that, while he might not get as much preparation in playing the game as other players because he has to work so much on the business side of things of Hearthstone, he is still aware. I mean, his website runs a meta report where they keep up to date with the latest deck list.
Yeah. Yep.
He literally has the deck list at his fingertips of, like, the latest deck list, and a lot of people have been tacking in this big game hunter.
He's surrounded by two deck builders and one caster as part of his team, so it's like every single aspect.
They get all the information. Mm. Yep. Yeah.
He got another prep.
That's pretty good.
That's nice.
Pretty good.
Well, it lets you fit in three mana at the end, and you don't know what you're going to use that on.
Probably Eviscerate.
Yeah, probably Eviscerate, we'll see what he gets. Yep, probably those two. It is nice that your opponent kind of threw out a frothing, especially since Reynad doesn't really have another one. So Reynad's kind of off the OTK plan, which maybe goes back to his self-proclaimed inexperience with the deck, or maybe he has a different plan in mind. He did have to play something, because his hand is at 10 cards.
Right? Yeah.
And he can't play Acolyte or Loot Hoarder or Battle Rage. Mm-hmm. So your options are really limited, but I still really like to save the frothings for the charge OTK. So now his hand, while he has a lot of cards, they're all just minions.
Yeah.
They don't really kill your opponent that well. Like Sludge Belter blocks some damage, that's nice.
I'm actually surprised he hasn't drawn into Emperor Thorsan yet.
Yeah, I'm sure that was what he was really wanting to draw. And this big game Hunter tech in Ostkaka's deck has just been dead every game.
Sort of. I mean, there was one game where he threw it out, and then Dr. Boom literally came out the next turn.
Right, that was rough. It helped a little bit in this one, right? It killed the 8-8.
Yeah.
Well, no, that
killed
was
his own
8-8.
That was Reynad's BGH.
Oh, just kidding. He got red by it.
This BGH in the Rogue has just been dead consistently.
Been dead. Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
He was getting BGH so much that he put one in himself.
Fortunately, it doesn't really work that way.
Nope.
So, yeah, this Lothab's awkward for Reynad, though. He doesn't have any way to answer it. Reynad's hand is just full of incredibly awkward cards. Made to fit. He gets to drop a lot this turn, though, thanks to the Dread Corsair. Yep. He's going pretty low. But Ostkaka has no damage. So.
The big thing he needs right now is sort of a whirlwind effect. He needs a way to generate patrons. He needs a way to be able to utilize Battle Rage. He needs a way to be able to proc execute without throwing things in.
Is he afraid to overcommit right
now?
Yeah.
That looks like what it is. He might just Loot Hoarder armor up. We know he doesn't have a Blade Flurry, but Reynad's very well. He's very well aware. He's 18 cards deep in his deck.
Mm-hmm. And we haven't seen one yet.
That's
there it is.
Whoa!
Yeah, there it is. It's still not that great here.
No.
You'll probably actually save it and just sprint this turn. Mm-hmm. The funny thing is Ostkaka's like afraid he's dead.
You always have to sort of keep that in the back of
your mind. Yeah, the Patron deck does a lot of damage, but Reynad's hand literally has zero damage.
You can take solace in the fact that you've already seen one Frothing Berserker, and sort of the way Reynad has been playing, it's
been awkward.
It's sort of shows you that he
I would
doesn't
consider
know what to do with his
attacking
hand.
The slime here to get through that taunt and re-daggering up. Because next turn you'll want to hit the face and then flurry, and I think that's what Ostkaka's thinking about when he went to hit the end turn button, but then he just paused and thought, wait, I have two mana. I can take one damage, which he's going to take anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not going to work too well with the Dread Corsair blocking the attack, but
yeah. And at the end of the day, he needs to piece together damage. He can't.
Yeah, he
just
needs
have
to push
to
a lot of damage.
Right.
Like he's been using a lot on minions.
He has no board. Reynad has had the initiative sort of the whole game.
He had to use two saps on Acolytes.
That
and then he got Belchered.
Especially when the Acolytes already drew one, too, and he had to sap it after.
Yeah, it's just ridiculous.
But once again, he's in a tough spot.
Yep.
Yep.
So what is Reynad thinking
Both
about
Both players
here?
Probably feel so bad, but like really, yeah. it's still anybody's game.
The draws this weekend have seemed to be tending towards the bad side.
There have
definitely.
Been multiple games where both players just draw atrocious.
Mm-hmm. We've only seen a few games where one player just had a ridiculous hand.
Right.
Yeah.
Players are. It feels like they're playing weak decks.
I was calling those games.
Yeah, yeah. It feels like the people are playing weak decks, is what it is.
Both players are 18 deep in their deck and still lacking,
yeah. still lacking
core within. Cards of their system.
They have like full hands.
Inner Rage.
I think he's going to save it for the OTK. And now we're at the point where a Warsong Commander, you're getting really close to lethal.
Yeah.
Also, no Death Spite in the top 20 for Reynad.
That's very
like
sad.
Like the best card in the deck.
Mm-hmm.
Like the best card? I think it is the best card. I know
it's
people.
It's the best card based on the context of the deck. Yeah. yeah.
People say, oh, it's called Patron Warrior. But Patron isn't even the star.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think there's really a... I was thinking maybe with these heals, Ostkaka could go for like a long-term game, try and run Reynad out of stuff, but don't think that'll work
so
very well.
The longer this game goes, the more Reynad's going to realize that he has to go for sort of that one-turn kill.
Right. Yeah, Ostkaka can get a minion down here for the oil and hit face and flurry. Now Reynad was saving the Dread Corsair to use it for a Warsong combo. So he's not gonna oil, he's just gonna develop a piloted Treader.
Yeah. I think he wants it to stick. He wants something to be able to proactively use the oil on instead
feels
of sort
so
of
so bad. When you flurry and they still have armor.
Yeah, it just builds up to exactly what they had before.
And there's Emperor. But still no Commander. Still no Deathbite. Commander, there,
there
it
we
is.
Go.
Probably not lethal, right? Each Enrage is only worth 3.
Right.
So that's only 14 damage this turn. Only.
Ooh.
Yeah. After the commander, though, or after the emperor, Reynad pretty much wins because you can play the corsair, yep. the commander, the frothing, inner rages on the patron.
Mm-hmm.
Just ridiculous amounts of damage.
Yep.
So, Ostkaka.
Is there a chance to go for Grim Patron here?
What?
Maybe see what comes out of the pilot of Treader?
Nah.
Yeah. Or just slam
you
down
just
emperor.
You just play emperor, you armor up, and that. That's probably game.
Yeah, I think
you could even play the Dread Corsair just to be safe, because you probably don't need it for your OTK.
Well, on the other hand, let's look at Ostkaka's hand and see how much damage he has.
Well,
yes, oil, he'll be left with some damage on the board.
Wow, what's going on here?
What's going on here?
Is this lethal? It can't be. It's 19.
So.
Is this 19 damage?
Wait, so 10. Oh, he's trading.
What is going on?
Maybe he didn't recognize that next
I
turn.
I really
he just
don't like that play at all. Won. Like that could lose him the game. He still has a lot of damage in his deck, but none in his hand. But there will be a flurry, and
yep, definitely.
Really unfortunate that Ostkaka can't get the oil onto the egg though.
Yeah. He's got like a 50-50 to do it.
No, he has no way. Because he has to use the mana to dagger up.
Yeah.
Cost 8 to do the oil flurry,
yep.
which he needs to
do. Oh, well, just oil.
Yeah, but then you can't flurry. So, yeah, he just sees the oil flurry play, goes for it. He knows he has a lot of healing. But now he's kind of out of stuff.
Yeah, this is what I was talking about. This is one of the ways that the warrior can take a win is if the rogue just runs out of damage, if they have to use their stuff inefficiently. That is sort of the epitome of inefficiency. You're not using the first charge of the oil, which is huge. You're missing
four
damage,
feel like
potentially
last
even
turn,
more.
If Reynad had just emperored,
he would have won.
He would have won.
He would have had over 30 damage.
This game would have been over.
You just cannot win. If you're Ostkaka, you can even play the Red Corsair to make sure you don't die.
This is hurting TJ physically,
but
face palming.
At the same time,
he's still going
to
win.
As Reynad would say, there's no justice. Ostkaka has no way to answer these.
He's got a lot of Drake.
He does have a lot of heal.
He could heal. Yeah. But that's sketchy. You can Drake and Healbot. If you draw an Eviscerate off the Drake, I don't think he's used both. I think he's only used one.
I think only one.
Yeah, I think so.
Then you could Evis the... I don't even know which one you Evis.
Ooh, stop.
Probably the 5-5, and then the other one becomes a 3-4, which isn't terrible.
He's probably going through his head right now. What cards does he have left? He's used both Enrages.
Reynad's hand is awful.
No Deathbite still.
No Deathbites.
Deathbite could be exactly what he needs.
Backstab is...
not useful.
Not what he wanted.
He can backstab his own egg.
Yep. Get a 4-4 out. It's like playing a 4-4.
Yeah. But you also kind of want it for removal.
Yeah, definitely.
I guess the 4-4 is removal.
Yeah.
Yeah, what?
I think he's doing it.
I think he's going to do it. Oh, he's going to heal himself. Okay. He's scared the Reynad has a whirlwind effect.
Yeah. Wouldn't he have used it?
Exactly.
Yeah, when he double enraged
him. When he double enraged, he would have killed him.
He would have been dead.
There's always a chance
he
top decks.
He can't top deck him.
This has to be a Death Bite coming out.
There's nothing that does 7 damage. Death Bite would do 8 over 2 turns.
Oh my god.
Worse.
And that's not that good.
That's not good at all. I don't think.
He can't make any extra patrons. He can run a patron into the 4-4 and execute it, which is just atrocious.
Sweet!
That would be value town.
Sweet. What now? And I kind of talked about Ostkaka could run him out of damage with the heal bot.
Yeah,
that might be a good play. I didn't think that was possible because you could just infer an OTK him. But
I'm just looking for something to say. Yeah, maybe he can run him out of damage with the heal
bot, right? You
know, Reynad looks like distressed.
That's the exact pose that I was in.
Yeah, that was your face palming pose. When
the rope has gotten him in tournaments before, like, and made suboptimal plays.
Yep.
Yeah. And now, okay, also. We know Ostkaka's hand is all minions, but he still has damage in his deck. How afraid are you?
Still has an oil if he runs two.
He has 7 on board. He has a spell power up. Can you realistically just hit his face, or do you trade? And if you trade, how do you win? Because you know he plays heal bot.
Oh, no, is this
you have
leading
to play around something here? What's going on here? Like,
is this the Grim Patron?
What's going on here?
Just your face.
Oh,
it looks like just
face. That's the right move.
Yeah, this is correct. With the hand context that we know.
All right, 7. I don't think there's any card.
He needs to draw, like, Eviscerate. Well, he doesn't need to draw anything. He has the heal.
Yeah.
But he really wants to draw something good here. And that's Eviscerate.
That is it.
Anti-Healbot, Eviscerate. He clears
the
board.
They play the BGH, and then...
Wow.
Wow.
That might...
Ostkaka's ahead.
Ostkaka's
going to win.
I'm pretty sure.
Wow!
With a double execute hand.
I don't understand. I mean, I'm very confident he'll make the play.
Is there another? I could randomly throw down the piloted shredder and just plop it down there.
I'll tell you what, guys. I've been very confident about a few things today.
That's true, actually. Never know anymore.
I've been let down, so...
He knows both Enrages are gone, so no Grommish Enrage off the top. I don't even think Reynad plays Grommish.
I don't think he'll even have enough time to, like, Death Spite
Reynad,
twice over two
turns. Yeah, that's
over three
the thing.
Turns.
He needs to do it three times, not just twice. And unless he runs Death Spite, Grommish, runner, I think that's going to be it. He didn't play the BGH, though, which I don't like, but I don't think that's going to change the clock is why he did it.
Oh, he can.
It might change the clock, though. And Reynad holds the task.
Almost out of cards,
which means he does have a Grom,
yeah,
maybe.
That's the only reason I think you'd hold it.
So I really would have liked to see BGH hit play last turn. There's an oil. It's going to be a 66% to hit.
And he needs to start putting on damage because he's on a clock.
He has one card left.
Can he hit it?
He hit the oil.
I think it comes down to...
Is this the draw?
The
this
Grom
is
draw?
No, he can execute the 6-3. He's not dead.
Okay.
Yeah.
But then he'd have to use the cruel task. Okay.
There's the first death bite.
Okay, he can hit face with death bite, get rid of the 6-3.
Armor up and hope for the Grom.
And Ostkaka is going to fatigue soon. This is Ostkaka's last card. What is it?
Oh, wow.
I don't think it's going to do 4 damage. Whatever it is, he's been through both eviscerates.
It's definitely not doing...
I haven't been tracking cards at all. I didn't think we'd get to this point.
I didn't think so.
The suspense!
It's so slow.
Flip the board!
What's happening. Okay, here we go.
That's terrible.
No, definitely didn't want to do that.
You don't have to trade with the 2-2, though.
4 cards left.
Wait,
one of those 4 cards is Grom.
I think he's super sad that he did not play the BGH last turn.
Do you have to trade with the 2-2? Can you? I guess it kills your 4-2.
Okay, so Reynad's last card.
I should have played that BGH.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, he's really bummed he did not play the BGH last turn.
So Reynad's last cards, one of them is a Death's Bite. One of them is a Grom.
We think.
We're assuming. With Cruel. Yeah.
He won a game with Gromby.
Did he?
Yeah. Oh. So we know that he has it.
Okay.
So he has a couple outs.
So there's a potential that it might be a 1-in-4 chance for Reynad to still win this game, despite what is arguably
one of the
poorest patron performances we've seen, at least in the past 2 days.
Right.
Yeah. He's not going to trade. Here. It's all face.
Because you know if he Grom.
But wait, Ostkaka's not going to have lethal next turn.
Did he not weapon up? Or is he afraid of Harrison?
Ostkaka won't have lethal next turn. And he's taking fatigue, so he's going to have another draw.
Oh my gosh. Wait. This is so funny. Yeah, he's going to have one more draw.
He gets one more
draw. Clear the 4-2. Armor up. And
he'll be
draw.
One off lethal.
I don't think Ostkaka.
And then it's a 2 out of 3 for Reynad to win. Death's Bite and Grom.
Oh my goodness.
Can Reynad screw this one up?
Can he?
That's the question.
Can he? Will he like attack with the weapon? Will he just go face?
Well, if he goes face, that's a bad idea.
I just can't tell what's going to happen anymore.
I guess when you're in the player pod, okay, every board state's a tough one.
Yeah.
This is a pretty simple board state.
They pump white noise into there. It's just you and your opponent in the admin
hiding
in the corner.
It's you and your thoughts.
It's a 2 out of 3.
Here we go.
For Reynad to win this game. That's the other card in his deck is Warsong Commander, which will do nothing.
No, it's not.
It's not.
I don't even know what the other
card
is.
Who knows, but it probably does nothing.
A 60.
What a game. Six.
It might be a fire.
Oh, is it? It could be. Actually, I think
it's at least 66.
It may be 100.
Reynad looking jaded in his battle rage. That should do it.
Jeez.
There it is. There's Grom.
Wow.
No justice.
No justice.
No justice.
You know, TJ,
in the world.
I don't think that match is going in the anime.
No justice.
Nope.
Ever. What a game.
Wow.
What a series. That's actually pretty heartbreaking for Ostkaka.
I'm sure.
If you played the big game hunter.
Yeah.
If you played the big game hunter, what we thought he would do, I'm surprised that he didn't recognize it would have led to him having lethal the next turn.
Yeah.
It wouldn't have because of the executes, but later in that game, he was 4 off exactly.
Right.
Yep.
It was exciting.
Really exciting.
Very exciting.
Yeah.
So.
We weren't keeping track of that last card. Battle Rage was.
Battle Rage.
So he had a 100% chance to win, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Reynad knew all along. It was all planned.
It was all planned.
That was it.
Just to get us riled up and excited.
Yeah. He calculated the damage. He's like, I'm going to be down to 3 cards.
Yep.
One of them is going to be Battle Rage.
One damage.
Yep.
Yeah, he's going to be one off at the very end. His last card's Phantom Dives. Yeah. Easy.
Wow. Really incredible. Well, unfortunately, Ostkaka is out of the tournament.
Yeah.
He played pretty well, but maybe his deck lineup maybe wasn't suited for his group or something along those lines. But definitely a big congratulations to Reynad. He had a few stumbles, but he found his way there at the end.
Did.
And again, it was kind of the story of the third deck, essentially.
Yeah.
Losing.
Yeah. Both players.
Handlock being kind of his, what Ostkaka considered his second best deck.
Right.
Yeah.
And he didn't bring Hunter. He brought Rogue instead. And
I think Reynad's showing
great.
That he says he's like never plays patron.
Yeah,
kind of showed a little bit too.
Reynad comes in with the mentality, I'm just going to bring the best decks. You know, I haven't practiced these at all. And it's showing that it still wins.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's all you need, the best decks.
Yeah. Well, we do have Frodan standing by on the stage with the winner of that last match, Reynad. So let's send it over to them.
All right, I'm joined by the winner of the previous series. It's Reynad from Tempo Storm. So Reynad, you know, I don't know if everyone was expecting the way it turned out to be, but what was going through your mind as the series came to an epic conclusion?
Well, I've been playing a lot of like ladder this week, and having played against Grim Patron a lot, I was kind of like raging every time I lost to the deck. So I figured, like, this weekend, you know, we have lots of wonderful R&D and Blizzard developers here. I'm like, how badly can I play this game and still win to maybe get them to nerf it, you know? But that was the thought process going into it, yeah.
Well, mission accomplished so far, and smooth sailing, because you're one round away of going to the top eight here. How do you feel like you can stack up against WLOS, who has some unusual decks here?
I mean, my decks are better, but I won't play them well, so we'll see, right? It evens out. I don't know. Honestly, I just feel bad for Ostkaka. Like, I think he was the best player in the group. It's like, I think unlucky for him to get paired against me, because Tempo Mage is one of like the better decks against his lineup, but because he gets that rogue win. But yeah, I don't know. I just hope I play Patron better. I've never had I was always playing this Unstable Ghoul list before that Just Saying gave me, and it was pretty straightforward. Like, you just play stuff and you attack with it, and then your combos aren't complicated. There's no inner rage. It's like very straightforward, like a mid-range deck. But then this list, it's playing like Loot Hoarders. You have those games where like you need to Emperor and set up these combos, and it, like, there's just like that one complicated turn where I ended up panicking because I never like played a macro game against Rogue before. I've like never played that matchup. I know Rogue's favored, but so yeah, I don't know. Like, I should have Emperored, but I was like scared of double oil or something. I don't know. I'll try not to do that again and play better. So.
Well, I guess you only have one direction, is to go up from this point. So I hope that you can recollect your thoughts. We don't want to take too much more of your time, but I guess the last thing is, how will you prepare for this upcoming match specifically? You know, do you feel like you can rebound? Because there were some, you know, close games, for example, not double fireballing instead of playing the 4-tank max, and then as a result giving up the game. Has that rattled you at all?
No, that play was correct, 100%. Like, they laugh at it. Are you kidding me? No, like, legitimately think about it. He'd already played one Molten Giant. He plays, what, maybe one BGH if he's lucky to? Like, what are the odds that he has BGH Molten, two one-ofs, to set up lethal and kill my tank, as opposed to him having one Jiraxis to win the game? Like, my play was just better there, I think, like, in a lot of ways. But, I don't know. If you can see the hands, yeah, it looks really bad, but, like you're not going to play around, like, three one-ofs or whatever. It's not right, so.
Well, the results speak for themselves. Congratulations on your win, as you will have a pretty upcoming challenge. But if you do it, you're into the round of eight, and you get at least $1,000 in some world championship points. So congrats, and good luck in the next round, Reynad. In the meantime, we're going to go ahead and give it back to the commentator's desk to see what they have to say about the upcoming series.
Thank you very much.